Good evening, YouTube. Well, I'm gonna do an update tonight on the dirt garden. You can see the back half of the bed at the front of the house is not planted at all yet. That's all hair from my sister's dog shedding. But right here, center frame, we have comfrey that is just been in our possession about 3 weeks and is doing wonderfully. Lemon balm has just been transplanted to this front bed. It's doing wonderfully. The anise hyssop is starting to come back quite nicely. What is that again? That's Mongolian yarrow, which is supposedly the most potent chemically of the yarrow plants. We have a lone straggler rose bush that just grew by accident. We've been allowing to grow. Got garlic chives here right underneath of it, in amongst the confusion of wood sorrel. We have bloody dock or bloody sorrel or red vein sorrel or red vein dock. All of those are common names for it. That I planted out last fall, and then we moved it this spring here. And then in behind it, we have two that I moved out of the aquaponics into the dirt garden. We have garden sorrel there, chives there. We have quite a few of the foxglove have come back. And then the other half of the garden here is just a shambles. So in the bed at the side of the house, the tulips are about finished. The daffodils are about finished. The hostas that we planted a week ago are just going bananas. Bleeding heart has come back and is starting to take off. Our rhubarb is going bananas. This is the rest of our French sorrel or garden sorrel. One tarragon that escaped the transplant, and right there center frame is a hyssop. I don't know whether that is the anise hyssop or the blue hyssop, because originally the blue hyssop was planted there and the anise hyssop was planted there. We have wormwood going bananas again. The wild riverbank grape that we transplanted a couple years ago is doing fantastic. And it has 100 or so flower buds starting. Don't know if you can pick it out or not. But right there, starting up the stockade fence, is Williamette hops. So my hops made it through the winter again. Sorry if the camera's really shaky, but I'm swatting mosquitoes left, right, and center here. Now, each one of these dark spots here is a painted mountain corn that we selected for a clear the skin on the outside of the kernel is clear on the side that is showing when it's still all on the cob, and red tinted where any two kernels would touch. Then we have, I'm on the wrong side of the garden, the signs are all up the other side. We have Chinese cabbage there, and leeks up at the far end of that row. The center row here is sorghum, a variety called Early High Gear. And then this one right beside the walking path is it's a sunflower. It's one we grew last year that did really well. It is Velvet Queen. Now we just put in this piece of page wire fence, and that is going to hold our trellising melons. We're trying a new variety this year that is from northern India, and our pickling cucumbers. Outside two rows have not been planted yet. Around behind us here, that's another wild riverbank grape, and our commercial beta grape did not do well at all. There's another view of the hops climbing up the stockade fence. And then there in the center of the wood chips, you can see another Williamette hops just starting. Our purple flowering raspberries have finally taken hold and are really healthy, so hopefully we'll get some fruit off of them this year. And then these are wild blackberries that have been transplanted, and wild brambleberries, which is like a blackberry, but it's a ground runner. We have at the back half here is all wild raspberries that have been transplanted, and then four or five different varieties of domestic raspberries out front, but most of the signs have been stolen by the squirrels. This bed hasn't been weeded yet, but that's all wild raspberries that have been transplanted in. We got the teepee back up, and it is planted with scarlet runner beans again this year. This trellis bed here is planted with green arrow peas. And in front are my Brandywine tomatoes. Which have already started to set fruit. Right behind me here, we have a bed full of chickpeas. Those three beds have not been weeded or planted yet this year. These other beds haven't even been filled yet. Our hay bale growing experiment has a hell of a lot of weeds on it, and some wild strawberry transplants that are doing quite well. And in the center there, come on, focus, is purslane. We put in a bed this year of dahlia, which is a beautiful flower, thick lush green plant with outstanding, beautiful flower, and I just found out this past winter that they are an edible. The roots are an edible. So we're putting in a couple of beds of dahlia this year to experiment with the edible roots. We've put in a bed that is stinging nettle and evening primrose. This is the next bed to get filled. It's going to be another dahlia bed. The saffron crocuses are doing quite well. The queen of the night tulips are looking just beautiful. We planted a replacement honeysuckle that I had started from seed. The one that we had originally planted here didn't take. It was one that had been wild collected. My black currants are doing fantastic. The red and white currants down at the other end are doing okay, though I haven't got this bed weeded yet. We've got a fair bit of the transplanted wild blueberries that have come back. The iris bed is doing beautifully. We don't consider milkweed to be a weed. We allow it to grow just about everywhere it comes up, because of the monarch butterfly situation. And we have a couple. These are wild Canada lily, and these are an Easter lily that my daughter's boyfriend gave her this past Easter, and when it finished blooming she gave it to me to plant. Lupins are about ready to flower, and we've got some new lupins this year planted. The lady slipper that we had to transplant last year because it came up in the roadway at the back of the property is doing just beautifully this year. We have black carrots, a Danvers type carrot, and purple dragon carrots in the first three quarters of this raised bed. We're going to be putting in a mixed carrot from seed here. We have just begun weeding this bed. This one section here is full of lady's thumb, which is a wild edible and is getting picked and dehydrated to go into our mixed dehydrated greens jar. And for the first time since we've been here, we have what looks to be touch-me-not, which is the cure for poison ivy, coming up in this bed, so we're not weeding that out. We have a whole bunch of carrots that I don't know where they came from coming up in this bed. We have garlic and red onions. This is some of the seed that I got. The lettuce here is some of the seed that I got from Sir Cracker. All of the trays are out of the basement green room now. We have rub broccoli ready to harvest. Only had two tatsui come up this year. Spinach did pitifully. And these are red scallions in the front, interplanted with Claytonia. More various lettuces and kales. Scarlet kale here, dinosaur kale there, red Russian kale back there, and tatsoi from seed we saved, but it looks like it may have crossed with the arugula last year. We had to move all of our sacred white sage out from the bed at the front because it was trying to strangle out everything. So this is taking off really well considering it's just been transplanted a couple weeks ago. Our horseradish, these ones were planted last spring. It's doing really well. We have flowers up on 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, at least 7 of them. The echinacea is starting to come back, Echinacea propaea. Some wild garlic mustard that I transplanted in to see how it does. The Jerusalem artichokes are starting to come back. We have a garlic mustard coming up in with my wild ginger. A whole bunch more Jerusalem artichokes, and then the old horseradish plants. These horseradish plants have all come from some horseradish starts that I bought more than 20 years ago and have moved with me a dozen times or more. These are potatoes from tuber. Our oregano we moved this spring is starting to be choked out by a red clover. We have gill over the ground, tarragon, and lovage. Anyway, that's it for the dirt garden update. That's it for now, and thanks for watching.